All right, the breaking news here from Lviv. We did hear the air raid sirens go off just moments ago. We're watching the skies very carefully. Obviously, there was a missile attack on this city over the weekend. The head of Ukraine's military intelligence is now warning that President Putin could be looking to carve this country in two, something like North and South Korea. I want to bring in Colonel Cedric Leighton. He's a CNN military analyst and retired Air Force Colonel. Cedric, thanks so much for being with us. You know, if you're talking about this kind of partition, what could that possibly look like in the Russians' eyes?
Yeah, John, it's very interesting because the minimalist way of looking at this would be that they would take this area right here, which is in essence the Donetsk-Luhansk area, and that would be a part of the pro-Russian territory. But the bigger piece, the one that is really the extreme piece, but was part of a Russian war aim for this conflict, would be to take a borderline that would roughly follow the Dnipro River. That would take all of eastern Ukraine away from the current Ukrainian government, the Zelensky government. They would get the west, the pro-Russian area would get the east. That would be the very extreme, economically difficult thing for the western side to deal with. But that would be, I think, the Russian thinking would be to take this and make this part of their sphere of influence.
Yeah, the former situation there would be something of a concession for the Russians. It would mean they would maybe leave the positions they've occupied in and around Kyiv, even though they haven't successfully been able to push toward the city. Cedric, the air raid sirens went off here moments ago. Obviously, there was an airstrike on this city over the weekend, and then a series of strikes on these fuel or infrastructure insulation centers kind of all around the country. Will you just show people on the map where Lviv is and where the Russians are shooting from and what they're shooting at?
Sure, John. Lviv is right here, where you are right now. Now, where the Russians are shooting at includes the cities of Lutsk, Rivne, and Zhytomyr right here, those three cities that are right in the northwestern part of the country. Where they're shooting from includes Belarus. So they're shooting remotely, basically. What they're doing is they're going in and they're taking these standoff weapons that they have, using them to target various areas that are, very conveniently, on the supply lines that the Ukrainians need in order to sustain their war effort.
Because the supplies are coming from where, Colonel?
They're coming from Poland, primarily, right here, Slovakia to a lesser extent, Hungary to a lesser extent, and Romania. So those are the areas where the supplies are coming in from. And this is why the Russians want to, in essence, cut off these supplies and make it very difficult for the supplies to reach places like Kyiv or Kharkiv or Dnipro or any of the other cities that the Ukrainians are trying to defend or retake.
I'm going to misquote, General Omar Bradley, who effectively said, what do you say, tactics are for amateurs, logistics are for professionals. What can this do? If you're blowing up fuel storage areas and other logistical centers the Ukrainians need, how disruptive can that be to the Ukrainian efforts to fight back?
It can be absolutely critical, John. One of the key things here, if we go in, let's just take a look at the Kyiv area, for instance, just to describe some of this. If you cut off the logistical support here, it would be impossible for the Ukrainians to even mount any kind of effort against Russian forces that are present to the northwest and the northeast of the city. They've already done a lot to move these forces back. It's a very difficult thing for them to do. But without any of those logistics supplies, it's going to be impossible for them to move forward. They need guns, they need ammo, they need food, they need fuel, just like the Russians did. And we have to remember, down in this area, remember that 40-mile convoy that was so famous or infamous that the Russians had that didn't go anywhere? Because of lack of fuel, lack of parts, all of those things would then be the Ukrainians' problems, and that would be disastrous for their war effort.
All right, needless to say, we're watching that all very closely. Colonel Cedric Leighton, thanks for helping us understand it. Appreciate it.
You bet, John.